Hello, my dear kids. Very good evening. This is Sundar Rabindranathan here. Hey guys, how are you doing, all of you? Let me see who are all here. Hi. Hi, Param. Hi, Varshini. Kanishka, hi. So guys, lovely to see all you guys. Welcome to this session where we are going to continue where we left. What books and burials tell us, right? Remember, we spoke about the Vedas yesterday. Our focus completely was on Rig Veda, correct? So we are going to continue, and our focus today is going to be on what burials tell us. What kind of information do we have on the different burials that have happened in the past? Okay? I will show it to you guys with pictures, so it's going to get a lot interesting. Okay? So as usual, we'll just leave a minute for a few more guys to jump in. And then we will start. Hi Sharvi, I'm fine. How are you? Hi Anjita. Hi Kushi Verma. Hello Adhirai. Yes. See, the entire books part ends with wish. Jana and wish, right? We spoke about those three types, right? It ends there. So the remaining we will be starting with burials now. Cool? Okay, awesome. Hi Kiran, I'm fine. How are you? Hi Nista. Hi Vaishnavi. Thank you, Miramadu. Right guys, I think we should move on. Yeah. Okay, so guys, in case you're wondering, what is this channel Vedantu Young Wonders? Typically, we handle 6th, 7th and 8th grade students. And four subjects are our focus areas: Math, Science, Social and English Grammar. Your entire year syllabus we will be covering throughout the year. Okay? And we also have an ICSE series happening. And you know what is the best part? All sessions are live sessions with quiz. Every session will be a live session with a quiz. Okay? Right. So now today that means we are going to have a live session which is right now happening. And we will also go with a quiz at the end. Right. Non-academically, we also have a How Does It Work series. Alright, where we explain the functioning of equipments around you. Simple equipments like web camera, touch screen, wall clock and whatnot. A lot of things. Okay. Right. On the other side, we also have a Spell Bee contest, which is happening on Sundays at 7 p.m. That's Vedantu Young Wonders for you guys. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Kids, in case you are looking to study deeper, you want to get all your doubts solved, you want the best teachers to teach you, you want beautiful notes to be given to you, you want recordings permanently for your reference, right? And you also want tests and assignments and someone to evaluate them, give you feedback on how you are doing. Watch out for this subscription on your screens now. Vedantu Pro, this is the subscription which has features, all these features which I just said. So you can visit this link vdnt.in/ytpro whenever you want to. Alright, and look at the subscription and choose the teacher's code SRPRO to get a very good discount. Cool? I hope you have taken a snapshot of it or noted this down somewhere. So once you go to vdnt.in/ytpro, you have to choose the grade. Which grade you belong to, choose this, click on get subscription, choose how many months of subscription you want. Six subjects are covered in this. Alright, Maths, Physics, Chemistry, Biology, English and Social. And to get a discount, that coupon, the teacher code which I gave you, please put it here. SRPRO. You will be able to get a very good discount, more than 30%. Okay. And once you subscribe, you will be taught by the best of teachers in India, the master teachers of Vedantu. And all that they teach will be in sync with your curriculum. Whatever you learn at school, right? In sync with that. Cool guys, that's about it. I think it's time that we start part 2 of what books and burials tell us. Cool? Here we go. So what is in store? What are we going to deal with? Words to describe people. Already we discussed a little. That's where we stopped with wish. 2. What are silent sentinels? It's all about the burials. All right, they are called Silent Sentinels, the Balliol Grounds. The story of the megaliths. What are megaliths? That also we'll see. And was there any social differences? Was there the burial different for a rich man? And is it different for a poor person? All right, what were the different occupations that were there at Inamgaon? Right, we will see all these things in detail. Cool? Okay, amazing guys. So, shall I move on? Give me a yo, guys. Let's see. Hi, Onkar. Wow, Rajan. Amazing. Hi, Fahima. Awesome. Hi, Halesh. Many, many more happy returns of the day, beta. May God bless you. Enjoy your day. Cool, moving on. Words to describe people. You know what, guys? Remember, we spoke about Rig Veda, right? And Rig Veda is composed of thousands of hymns. Specifically, around 1028 hymns. And someone who composed these hymns, they called themselves as Aryas. Right? So, first thing you have to remember is, people who compose the hymns, they describe themselves as Aryas. And on the other side, they had their opponents. They are called Dasas or Dasyus. They did not involve themselves in any kind of sacrifices, but they spoke different languages. They are called Dasas or Dasyus. So Aryas composed those hymns, and their opponent Dasas or Dasyus, they didn't compose anything, but they spoke a lot of languages. So Dasas, alright, that means slave. On the other side, feminine form of Dasa is Dasi. Dasi they call it. Dasi, you know, both meant slaves. So these slaves were captured in the war. And just because they were captured in the war, they were treated as the property of their owners. These people were enslaved like that. The owners were, they were the property of their owners. How sad. But that's how life was, guys. The culture was like that. I'm sure again I want to refer you guys to that picture, Apocalypto, right? Where they suddenly come, conquer the entire forest, take all the people as slaves, right? Exactly like that. So now you know the different words that I use to describe people, typically Aryas and Dasas, Dasyus. Alright? So here we go. Moving on. Now coming to the burial ground. Guys, look at that pictures, both the pictures. Many times we don't even know what are these pictures, right? We would see something similar in the past, somewhere, wherever you, if you have toured throughout the world, you know, many places you will find something like this. But remember, these are called as megaliths. We thought, so, wow, look at that, such a big stone is there. But actually, these are burials. So that means under them, someone has been buried. These stone boulders, right, at the top and the side, which provided support, they are called as the big ones. They are called as megaliths. Right? People who did the burial, right? They carefully arranged these stones. And to ensure that they locate and mark the burial sites, they kept these megaliths. Clear? Everyone clear? What is a megalith now? Arjun. Arjun is asking, sir, who clicked this? These pictures such a, you know, long time ago. No, 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 Arjun. These pictures were clicked recently. Probably 100, you know, years ago or so. So, they were existing. And even now, a lot of megaliths are there. Okay. They were buried or they were created, they were constructed thousands of years ago. Okay. Right. So, the practice of erecting megaliths under, you know, above the burial ground, it started 3000 years ago. Where in India, in Deccan, alright, South India typically, Andhra Pradesh typically, in Northeast and in Kashmir. Three places where South India typically we have in, you know, AP, Northeast India and Kashmir. So now you know what is a megalith. Under the burial site, above that they keep huge towns and supported and to mark the burial sites. They are called megaliths. And it started 3000 years ago, we had these places in India. Pranjay and Bhavya, what is your question? Okay, Anvi is asking, sir, where people are buried? I will show you those pictures, Anvi, right now. Don't worry, be ready. Meena Kumari, mentee will be there. Don't worry about this. This question is, it should not come at all in Vedanta Young Wonders. Sharvi is asking, sir, is there a human being under them? Yes, yes, yes. Okay. They are not potholes. Simija, they are called portholes. Portholes and potholes are different. Alright, portholes are like windows. Alright, say for example, there are times, Simi, this is for you. There are times when the entire family members are buried in the same place. So first one person is buried. So now later, after a few years, another person dies. Oh, what will you do? So there are portholes inside which they can, you know, the people take them and bury them in the same place. To enter that site, they use those portholes. Cool? Okay, kids. So now some megaliths can be seen on the surface. You see it on your screens even now. But some megalithic burials happen underground. Archaeologists, when they excavate, guys, so many very interesting things have happened when archaeologists excavate. You will find a lot of, you know, the skeleton will be there. And along with that, so many jewels will be there. Food will be there. A lot of stuff will be there. So some archaeologists found a circle of stone boulders or a single large stone standing on the ground. For archaeologists, it is a signal. It's an indication that there is some burial which has happened underneath. Interesting, isn't it? So these are only indication that there are burials underneath. Cool? Awesome. I hope you guys are finding it interesting. Neelam, yes, you have. We have mentee. Fahima is asking, sir, if someone has already died, I want to bury them. Let me just bury them and go. Why are they doing all these things? Guys, no, not like now. They respect people, alright, they worship people. And when you just like that bury and go, after some time, probably a year later, 10 years later or so, you want to locate them, worship them, do rituals on them, it's not possible. But when you keep these kind of, erect these kind of megaliths, you will be able to locate the site. That's the point. Okay, so what did people do to make megaliths? So this huge stones, how do people, you know, construct them? First, they locate a stone. They find a suitable stone. Then they break boulders. Boulders are the small stones which you see, right? Like for support. They transport these stones. They dig pits in the earth. Okay, they shape the stones, bury the dead, and place stones in position. Okay, you see that picture around you? The second one, right? They dig the earth, but before that, they create the large stone, the boulders, everything, they keep them ready. Guys, it's not easy. They are very, very heavy. Tamanna, when once a person expires, dies, right? There are different ways to pay respect to that person, alright, to bury that person. There are multiple ways. And these are called as burials. Burials can happen in different ways. Okay? So typically, in olden days, people had this habit, culturally, they had the habit of digging a pit, putting that person around them, they already identify huge stones. The boulders kept around it as boundaries. And then one large stone above them. Okay, this is a megalith process. Megalithic burial process. Kids, tell this, are you clear? Give me a yo. Sudev, you can call them as gravestones. But they are normal stones only. Just because they are placed in a burial site, you can call them as gravestones. Okay. My dear kids, till this you are clear? Hi Vinita, welcome back. How are you? Yeah, any questions? I am going to move on. Let me see if you guys have any questions. Okay, no questions. Awesome. Yes, Dilip, yes. Guys, boulders is a rock, guys. It's a huge rock, that's it. Huge stone. Breaking boulders is, in the burial site, there is one stone which is kept as an indication. But around that site, they break the boulders and find, you know, I showed this picture, right? Are you able to see that small, small stones? See here. In this picture, one large stone will be there, around which small, small stones will be there. These are called up. This is what they meant by breaking boulders. Cool. Okay. Now you can see. Typically, see there are small stones and you also have the large stones. So dead were buried with distinctive pots, different colors, black and red were pots. This is another culture, custom. Tools and weapons of iron were kept for different people. So along with the buried, they also keep, even now there are customs in India where people keep food, people keep flowers, a lot of things, right? So tools and weapons of iron were kept there. And skeletons of horse and horse equipment were kept. Guys, if you ask me, I will not have an answer. If you ask me, sir, why were the skeletons of horse and horse equipment kept? I don't have an answer. But why are we speaking about it? It is because during excavation, we identified these things. Archaeologists, when they did the excavation, they found skeletons of horses and horse equipments. So I am trying to explain to you what all things were found in the burial sites. Cool? Ornaments of stone and gold. If they are very rich, you know, for rich people, they keep the gold also, some gold also along with them. Now let me see if you guys have any questions. Aviral, generally there were no tombs underneath. Generally you can find when you go to Egypt, a few places, tombs are there, but not in this part of the country like India. No. Cool? Okay, finding out social differences. How were the rich buried? How were the poor buried? So archaeologists think objects found with the skeleton, that object belongs to the dead person. So there are times when, you know, a lot of objects are found. Okay, depends on graves. In few graves, they will find few objects. Few graves, they find a lot of objects. Example, Brahmagiri, there was one skeleton with, see the picture, guys, are you able to see? Brahmagiri, one skeleton buried with 33 gold beads, 2 stone beads, 4 copper bangles and 1 conch shell. Interesting, isn't it? Brahmagiri, I think it's in Karnataka. Okay? Cool? Yeah, Pranjay is saying, sir, we kept goat. Guys, it is in respect of people, guys. Respect of people. For a few people, whatever they like the most, they keep that along with them and while burying. So that is it. That's a custom, nothing else. Awesome. So now I hope you guys are clear. So on the other side, there were skeletons which did not have anything, just a few pots. So that means it clearly indicates social differences were there. People in high status, they had these gold, jewels, etc. People who were poor, etc., they did not have anything. So even those days, we had these social differences. That's the point that we are making. Cool? Awesome. So were some burial spots meant for certain families? Okay, look at these burial spots. You know, we look like this like tourists, right? Wow, look at how these stones are standing. But actually, these are burial sites. So sometimes megaliths contain more than one skeleton. So that means what? The entire family, chances are that the entire family is buried in one place. So that means one person is initially buried first, and someone who died later on, they were brought into the same grave through portholes. I told you, right? Portholes are kind of small openings or windows. Okay? And they brought them inside the portholes, the other dead people, and keep bury them the same place as that of their family members. So stone circles or boulders placed on the surface, they are like signposts to see which person is buried where. Any questions? No. Sudev, it's not just for soldiers. We don't have that data, frankly. Whether these are that of soldiers, we don't have that data. IAS Topper's Quest. Anyhow, we have Spenby at 7, right? On Sunday. Awesome. Thank you, Hemant. Tamanna, sir, that time people respected a lot compared to now. Frankly, if you ask my personal opinion, yes. People had a lot of respect for people. Now people are, everyone is running after something, right? It's quite funny to watch that. People run after that. They keep running after money. They keep running after, you know, fame, etc. Suddenly they turn back and see that they are old and die. Don't do that, kids. Don't do that mistake, okay? Don't run after something. Hold on and play. Stand in a place and play your game. Your own game, what you like. It's my suggestion. Do it the way you want. No, Ajay. Sir, our people are foreign. No, they are Indians also. There are people from this part of the country also. I told you, right? Sites in Brahmagiri, I just told you. I also said we had people in northeastern Kashmir, AP, one of them. Okay. So, Inamgaon, it's a site on the river Godh, a tributary of Bhima. These were, guys, thousands of years ago, these existed. There, they found this. They excavated this. They found adults were generally buried in the ground, laid out straight, with head looking at the north, no, towards the north side. And surprisingly, some burials happened within the, you know, vicinity of their houses, in the premises of the houses. And along with their burial, the dead person, vessels that with food, water were also placed with the dead. Where all this happened? Inamgaon. Okay? Right. So, my dear kids, typically, look at this. Look at one example. Hey, not that Bhima Stone circles means it's just the arrangement, guys. We mean only the arrangement of circle, you know, stones. Priyadarshini Pandey, lot of sites are there. I'll check and refer you. Don't worry. Okay. Great to hear that. This is electronic site, electronic age. Yeah, electronic age only. Okay, guys, now coming back. Look at that person, buried person. One man was buried in a large four-legged clay jar. Okay, it's a clay jar in the courtyard of a five-room house. The house also had a storeroom. The storeroom is called as granary, right? Granary. Yeah. The body was placed in a cross-legged position. See guys, don't ask me why, because we don't have answers for a few. But we are just trying to tell you these excavations have happened. Archaeologists, you know, found all these things out. Inamgaon, okay? Inamgaon is a place in Maharashtra, guys. It's a village. So archaeologists have also found seeds of wheat, barley, rice, pulses, millets, peas and sea same. And many animals were used as food. Alright, cattle, buffalo, all these animals, what are mentioned there. Fruits like bear, amla, jamun, dates, variety of berries were also collected. All these things were identified during the excavation by the archaeologists. Cool? Okay. Srija, if you close and open, sometimes ad might come. So don't close at any point in time. Kids, I think we are done. Tell this, are you clear? Mira Madhu saying, sir, for blood flow, they kept it like cross-legged. After death, what blood flow? I don't know. Cool, guys. Hi, Yogendra. Kids, are you ready for a mentee? Give me a yo. I hope the session was pretty interesting, right? People, how did burials happen early times? Yeah? So now I think we have had a fair share. We dealt with multiple things. We started with books. Now we dealt with burials. Now it's time for us to get into mentee. You guys are clear? If you have any questions, shoot. Otherwise, ask me for, give me a yo and ask me for a mentee code. I'm going to give it to you. Sir, was occupation more that time or now? Navya, definitely now. Now we have micro skills, right? Small skills are also occupations now. That was not the case. That time the same person did everything. Alright, the same person was hunting, the same person was doing agriculture, the same person was doing multiple things. But for now, for everything, there are micro skilled workers. So there are a lot of occupation now compared to early times. Cool? Okay. Ali Khan, how are the skeleton skill there, sir? They don't really get destroyed that easily, you know, right? Manoj Sharma, what is your question? Put me the question, I can explain to you. Poonam is asking, sir, why do they put pots in next to the person? Guys, it's not just pots. Something inside the pot, they keep something close to that person, something the person likes. As I said, we don't have strong answers, clear answers. But this is what we feel. Because we do it, right? There are different customs even now in India where people, whatever they kept, right, were close to their heart. When someone dies, they put that along with that person. Okay, right guys, moving on. So I want all of you to open a separate browser window and type www.menti.com, M-E-N-T-I, menti.com. I'll give you the code for today's mentee. The code for today's mentee. 4168890. I repeat the code, my dear kids. 4168890. You have to open a separate window, a browser window. Don't close the current one. And type the mentee code 4168890. Come on, guys, come on. 4168890. Guys, exactly in 1 minute's time, I'm going to start the quiz. Be ready. Raj Gaming, you have to go to this website www.menti.com. Abhinaya, Subhanallah, you should get. Are you typing the spelling correctly? Open Google Chrome window, type menti.com. Come on guys, type the website name, menti.com, and this is the code for it. Once again, I repeat, 41688890. This is the code, guys. All right, I'm going to start the first question in 30 seconds time. Be ready, all of you. Yep, we'll call back. Okay, I think it's time. First question on your screens. Here we go. On which bark was the Rig Veda written? Yeah. Neem bark, cinchona, tulsi or birch bark? If you have opened your textbooks, it's a cakewalk question for all of you. Because clearly it's mentioned there. With the picture. Okay, 116 of you got this right. Awesome. Guys, it's birch bark. That is normally the birch tree is one where lot of writings have been written in the past. Pratham, Raghav, Aditi, Bhavesh and Tanush. Top 5. Anurag, Swarna, Pari, MS, MSD and Supergirl. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So guys, question number 2 for all of you. In which region was the Rig Veda composed? Northeast, Northwest, North-South, Western region. Again, this is in the book, from the book. We have picked it from the book. Rig Veda is composed from the region. Guys, I am super happy. Most of you are giving right answers. I am very happy about it. Keep it up, guys. Keep it up. Come on. Time is running. 104 of you got this right. Okay. So, many of you said northeast. No, guys. Northwest is the... Rig Veda was composed in the Punjab region. Alright. Right now, Punjab is kind of there between India and Pakistan, right? Punjab region. So... Pratham, Raghav, Bhavesh, Swarna, Param, top 5. Oh, sorry, Vajresh and Param, top 5. Pihu, Swarna, Shivanshu, Beyonce and Narendra, Modi. Okay, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Kids, question number 3 for all of you. Be ready. Raj Gaming. When the dead body was buried with gold, it means that the dead man was rich man, poor man, chief, follower. I think I explained this even today, very clearly. So there is no way you guys can go wrong on this. 220. Of you got this right. Massive. It's a rich man, right? Typically. So Pratham, Raghav, Bhavesh, Shreyas and Pihu, top five. Swarna, Narendra, Beyonds, Barnala, and Mudita. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Kids, we are on to question number 4 right now. Come on, come on, come on. Let's see who's gonna win. The evidence of which fruits were found? I spoke about some 2-3 fruits. Bear, amla, and jamun, mango, pineapple, banana, apple, grape, and orange. All of these. There is no way you guys can go wrong on this. I'm pretty sure about it. Abhinaya, what is your question? You're not able to open. But I don't see it's a simple thing. Are you properly opening from your Google browser? Chrome browser. You have to open menti.com. menti.com. Dilip, Inam Gaon. Inam Gaon is a place, man. It's a place in Maharashtra. It's a village. So don't ask me the meaning. No, I don't know. So, 149. Ber, Amla, and Jamun, guys. So, 149 of you got this right. Let's see how many of you. Pratham, Raghav, Bhavesh, Shreyas, and. Okay, Beyonds and Barnala. Top 5. Narendra Modi, Shreyas, Suvarna, Param, and Arjun. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Guess question number 5. Brahmagiri is a site of megaliths. It is situated in which state? Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Uttar Pradesh, Kerala. I already spoke about it, guys. Don't make a mistake here. If you have listened carefully to the session today, you would be able to get the answer bang on. Let's see who's doing what. Wow, many of you more got it wrong. Very surprising. Karnataka is the right answer. So, Raghav, Bhavesh, Pratham, Barnala, Narendra Modi, top 5. Pihu, Swarna. Hey, do two Parnala are there? I'm cancelling one. Pugi, Arjun, and Shaurya. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, question number 6 for all of you. Adults were buried with their head towards which direction? East, west, north, south. Hi Sharad, how are you? Time is up. 142 of you got this right. Superb, guys. Raghav, Bhavesh, Pratham, Narendra Modi, Pihu, top 5. Swarna, Arjun, Nitin, Shaurya, and Ritu. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Awesome, kids. Here we go. Probably question what? Number 6, right? 6 or 7. Last question. The people who composed the hymns, they describe themselves as Dasas, Dasyus, Aryas, none of these. In Rigveda, the people who composed the hymns, they describe themselves as what? Time is running, kids. Wow, 153 of you got this right. Arya, superb guys. Wow, it's a tie, guys. It's a tie. Wow. Pratham, great job done, Raghav. And Pratham, guys, great job done. And Bhavesh, Narendra Modi, Suvarna, Nitin, Shaurya, Rutu, Ayushman, super. Guys, all you guys, great job done. Keep it up. All right. Congratulations to every one of you. I hope you guys did a great job, guys. Hey, guys, how was the session? Did you guys enjoy it? We understood how burials took place and what were these huge stones called megaliths and what was the customs that were there, keeping gold, keeping food, keeping water, keeping pots. All right, we learned a lot. So guys, if you like the session, hit the like button, let me know you liked it. And in case you haven't subscribed, do subscribe to the channel, guys. Hey guys, 8 o'clock, we have a beautiful session on common errors that we do when it comes to a subject verb agreement. This is for all across grades. You can attend. Common errors in grammar, especially for a reader, right? Common errors with respect to a subject verb agreement is what we are going to deal with. So I will meet you at 8 p.m. Until then, bye bye, guys. Catch up.